Good evening and welcome to Poland Daily. I'm Nicholas Richardson and this is the news. Germany confirmed United States administration plans to waive sanctions on the company behind Russia's Nord Stream 2 pipeline to Europe and on its chief executive. German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas welcomed the move as constructive. Kremlin spokesman Dmitry Peskov said it would be a positive signal if it turned out to be true. Central and Eastern European allies of the United States are on the alert, since the Biden administration has openly spoken out against the pipeline. The online publication Axios broke the news last evening. The authors reported that Washington is set to waive sanctions on the Nord Stream 2 AG, the company overseeing the construction of the pipeline, as well as sanctions on Matthias Warnig, a former East German spy and a personal friend of President Vladimir Putin. United States Secretary of State Antony Blinken and German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas spoke yesterday, and the US sanctions against the pipeline were on the table. US officials had not denied the news published by Axios, while Blinken stated that he is against this project. Maas confirmed the deal.
There is a presidential waiver for the Nord Stream 2 company and its CEO. We see this as a constructive step, which we are happy to further discuss with our partners in Washington.
Als einen konstruktiven Schritt, den wir gerne mit unseren Partnern in Washington weiter besprechen.
The pipeline, which runs 764 miles under the Baltic Sea between Russia and Germany, has long been criticized by both the Trump and Biden administrations, with opponents saying the pipeline will embolden Russia and destabilize Eastern Europe. Media are quoting United States State Department sources who say that trying to stop the pipeline outright by imposing sanctions on Nord Stream 2 AG and its CEO, Matthias Warnig, would alienate Germany, a key ally in Europe. They also point out that the final call on what sanctions to impose came from the White House. Republicans have accused the Biden administration of handing Russian President Vladimir Putin a strategic advantage in Europe. According to Representative Michael McCaul, any waivers would indicate the administration was never planning to stop the pipeline, despite Secretary of State Antony Blinken telling Congress that the administration opposes it. The German media reported with great satisfaction that the last obstacles to complete the construction of the Russian-German Nord Stream 2 gas pipeline have been overcome. The German shipping office also agreed to complete the investment in German territorial waters. More and more experts say that there are no economic reasons to build the next two lines of the gas pipeline. The German government is of a different opinion and believes that the gas pipeline is needed by the entire European Union.
The coronavirus pandemic continues to recede in Poland. The health ministry announced 2,344 new infections of coronavirus from 58,000 tests performed. A further 329 people have died.
Since the onset of the epidemic, over 2,850,000 people have been infected with SARS-CoV-2 in Poland. 72,000 people have died. So far, over 16,370,000 vaccinations have been performed. The first dose has been given to nearly 12 million people, and two doses to more than 4.5 million. In the last 24 hours alone, over 314,000 vaccines have been administered.
Coronavirus infections and hospital admissions are falling so quickly that the government has decided to close some temporary hospitals. The activities of the National Hospital, a temporary COVID hospital organized at the National Stadium in Warsaw, will be suspended and the last patient will be discharged on the 23rd of May.
It was the first temporary hospital we built to respond to the COVID-19 pandemic. The hospital was built within 2 weeks of the Prime Minister's decision. 17 days after the decision to open the facility, the first patient went there. In total, over 1,800 patients passed through. All the procedures that have been developed here, both technically and medically, are described. I want to thank all the crew and everyone who supported us. There were hundreds of people from all over the country who showed up knowing that the situation was very difficult.
Since its inception, Tygodnik Solidarność has been called the first free magazine from the Elbe to Vladivostok. It gave hope to millions of people, especially those on the wrong side of the Iron Curtain. As part of the 40th anniversary of the magazine's creation, an exhibition presenting the fate of Tygodnik Solidarność in the global context of the history of the struggle for freedom of speech has opened today in the hall of Warsaw's Central Railway Station.
We want to go out to people with this exhibition. We want it to be accessible, not closed somewhere in four walls where it is difficult to enter. Knowing about the Solidarity Weekly should be easily digestible, so we present it in a comic book form and available wherever people are. For example, in the hall of the railway station.
where such an exhibition can be viewed easily and pleasantly at the Central Railway Station in Warsaw. Of course, there are also versions of the exhibition in other languages.
That's the news. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for the weather, Poland Daily Business, and more programs. But from me, it's have a good night and a better tomorrow.